Welcome to the next set of official ACT problems. Each of the variables t, w, x, y, and z represents a different positive real number. Given the equations below, which of the four variables, w, x, y, and z, necessarily has the greatest value? Now, realize that t is going to be always the same value, right? So whatever t that you choose, whatever number for the variable t that you use, it's going to remain the same on the right side. So you can treat the right side as a fixed number, okay? So basically, let t be equal to 1 for simplicity, okay? So if you solve for w using that, you will get w is equal to 1 over 1.23 t, right? X will be equal to 1, sorry, I forgot, we're not using t anymore because we substituted the t for 1. So x will be equal to, let me use a different color, x will be equal to 1 over 1.01, right? Let's choose another color for y. Y is equal to 1 over 0.99. And finally, z is equal to 1 over 0.23. So the trick here is that you don't need to use the calculator to see which one is going to be the greatest result. The trick here is this. Look at the numerator. The numerator is always going to be 1. Okay? Now the denominator will work inversely to the overall result. So the greater the denominator, the smaller going to be the number. Okay, that's the trick that you have to realize. You do not have to waste time finding out the number in your calculator. Okay, use the fraction and do not really evaluate this fraction in your calculator. So just notice which denominator gives you the smallest number. Okay, obviously the z, this one, right? It's the smallest denominator out of all these four. So it will give you the largest number. Okay, just think of this. This is an example. 1/4 is greater than 1/8, right? But the denominator in 1/4 is smaller than 1/8, right? So the smaller the denominator, and the numerator has to be the same, obviously, right? That's why I said the t is equal to 1. So when the numerator is the same and the denominator is larger, let's say, than the second fraction in question, then that fraction will be smaller as a result. So the denominator works inversely to the number itself that you get. So the smaller the denominator, the greater going to be the fraction itself, the number. Okay, moving on to the next question. Each side of the smaller square in the figure, okay, so the correct answer was z. Each side of the smaller square in the figure below is x inches long, and each side of the larger square is c inches longer than a side of a smaller square. The area of the larger square is how many square inches greater than the area of the smaller square? So first we have to know that the area of the smaller square, okay, area of smaller square is x times x, right, is equal to x squared, right? X multiplied by the x. Because this is a square, it's really easy, right? It's just x squared. Now, the dimensions of the larger square will be x plus c, right? So side of a larger square is x plus c. And how do I know that? Because not only you can tell from the figure, but it also says that in the description. It says that each side of the larger square is c inches longer, that's the key word, longer than a side of the smaller square. Right? So x plus c must be the side of the larger square. So now area of the larger one is x plus c multiplied to itself, right? X plus c. Okay? So now the trick here is to avoid writing out this completely and then avoiding of subtracting the smaller area, right? Because the area of the larger square, if you want to find the difference, you just have to subtract the area of the smaller square from the area of the larger square, right? There are two ways, right? So either you can write this out, so you can do the FOIL method, x squared plus 2xc plus c squared minus the area of the smaller square, right? That's going to be x squared. So you know that the x squares will be eliminated, so you will have 2xc plus c squared, right? That's the answer choice. But there's another way. You can actually find the area using the figure, okay? So you can simply multiply the x, because you know that this is x, right? So you can basically work in partitions. You can find the area of this sector, and then you can find the area of this sector and then add these two results up, right? So the area of this sector will be x plus c, right? Because this is x plus c, this part, this side. And this is c, right? So it's going to be c times x plus c plus the area of this sector with the blue color. So this is x and this is c, right? So plus cx. So your result will be cx squared plus c squared. Okay, so let's see, x plus c multiplied by c, cx plus c squared plus cx, yeah, that should be correct, and that gives you 2xc plus c squared, right? So you achieve the same result just working by the figure itself. So two ways. Choose whichever method is better for you. I'm not sure which one's faster to tell you the truth, because it depends on how good you are with the geometry visuals. If you're really good with seeing geometry, then I would recommend using this method, working with a figure. But if you want to work algebraically, and if you're better at that, if you're faster at that, then use the algebraic method like this, and just subtract the area of the smaller square from the area of the larger square, so you get the difference, and that corresponds to the shaded region area. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next set.